Hey, what is up? It is Xantho, and another quick video. I know I'm spamming videos out left and right, but I get really excited theory crafting, and I like to share my theory crafts with people and updates on the builds. So I figured out that if you take a Righteous Decree, which is good because it reduces mana cost and increases mana by a ton, and the Vitality Life Mastery, the Vitality Reservation Life Mastery, we can fit in Clarity level 21, Purity of Elements, Malevolence, and Vitality level 21, and still have 124 mana left over, which is more than enough considering our main skill only costs 61 mana. So we have like double the cost of the thing, and we have 100 mana regen. So we're never gonna run out of mana. No mana issues ever. Reason I have pride in here is the gems have not been updated in POB yet. None of the gems have been updated. So Purity of Elements remains at 35% reservation in POB, so I'm putting a pride in here just to show that yes, you have 144 mana left over with a 50% mana reservation aura, but you're gonna have mana to cast stuff. And then I have switched over to a Vixen's Entrapment rather than a wind than Windscream Boots. Windscreams are like 5 C at the beginning of a league, and Vixen's Entrapment's usually like 2 C at the beginning of the league, so cheaper. They give an additional curse, just like Windscream. And it also gives cast speed with curses, which is great quality of life because you're going to be casting curses all the time because that's just part of how you use Hexblast. But the big thing is it triggers socketed curse spells when you cast a curse. So when you cast your Hex, your Doom curse, Flammability, which gains Doom via Doomsday, it's going to trigger Despair and Elemental Weakness. Socketed into Vexen's Entrapment, which means there's one less button to click on bosses and tanky enemies, which is huge. Removing buttons to click is big. And then I've switched around stuff. I've realized that Flame Surge is likely not going to be able to support it by support gems, so I'm throwing in Flammability Enhanced Faster Casting. And our Flammability is now pretty quick. It's got a 3.9 cast rate, which means the cast time is like, let's see, 0.26 seconds, so that's really quick for a curse, which is great. We're still using a Doedri's Scorn because it gives like 80% increased damage, because it gives 20% increased elemental damage and then 20% per with ailments per cursed enemy, which we're gonna have three, so that's 80% increased damage and some curse duration, which is it's okay. We're going to be repeatedly recursing because you're going to need to recurse after you ignite the enemy. Because what you want to do is you want to curse the enemy with Flammability, which is then going to trigger Despair and Elemental Weakness. Be sure to drop your Scorching Ray Totems first. So Scorching Ray Totems, curse with Flammability, which is then going to trigger Despair and Elemental Weakness. Hex Blast, and then recurse it with Flammability, because you can recurse it with Flammability because the Hex Blast removes the Hex. The Hex with the most doom, but you can also just recurse it with flammability, which is pretty cool, and that'll make it take extra damage. So our damage is about 1.162 million, about 9 million per ignite, plus about 600,000 from Flame Surge. If those numbers stay the same, they might be nerfed a little bit, but they initially said 50% of the ignite is going to be created as burning ground. That might be nerfed because they removed the 50% line and they simply say a percentage. I'm guessing that's because it's going to scale with gem level. It might still be 50%, but it might scale with gem level. So they don't want to just say it's 50% because it's, not a static number. Similar to how the new poisonous concoction is base 3% of your life flask, and now it's actually going to be 9% because Ziggity kind of leaked some information. So, but faster casting is good because it's going to make your Flame Surge really quick and your Flammability really quick, which is going to be huge for clearing and bossing. So my Flame Surge got almost 4 casts per second, so that's pretty darn good. And we've saved up some jewel sockets, some gem sockets, sorry. No, yeah, jewel sockets. Because we dropped the links from Flame Surge, so which means we can now go a Scorching Ray Totem setup, 4 link Scorching Ray Totem setup instead of a 3 link, which means we can now get to 8 stacks per totem, which means we're going to be doing about 20-30% more damage, due to being able to use efficacy. And the fact that efficacy gives skill effect duration, which makes us able to get hit 8 sacks, so it's actually probably more like 30 to 40% extra damage from your Scorching Ray totems, not overall. So your totems are doing 64,000, and we're going to have 3 of them, which means that's like, you know, 190,000 or so, 192-ish. 192,624. I still have this as level 24 because the gems, once again, have not been updated yet, so they're going to be dealing about 600 and something DPS, 6650, and this is 666, so slightly more than it's actually going to be. But 23 is just way too low, so... So, that's pretty much the changes to the broke version. I'm kind of actually debating whether to use Vixens and Traven in the cheap and the endgame version, because Vixens and Traven just saves your bacon by not having to cast the Bane Curse in addition, which is just going to save you a lot of clicks, and also it's going to increase your clear DPS, because whenever you cast Flammability, a group of enemies, they're also going to be cursed with Elemental Weakness and Despair. So they're going to be taking a lot more extra damage. And since they're normal enemies, magic enemies, rare enemies, they're not going to be affected by the less curse effectiveness that bosses like Cirrus and Guardians and Shaper are going to have. So those curses are going to be full effect. And they're going to be way into the negative on resistances. And they're going to be taking a lot more damage from Despair, because Despair gives damage over time. Even though we're not Chaos yet, we're not going to be going Black Flame until we get the endgame version, because Black Flame is likely going to be pretty expensive. But Despair does have the line of cursed enemies take 35% increased damage from damage over time effects, and also gives 46-37 damage to hits against cursed enemies, which is good, because Hex Blast is a base Chaos curse anyway, so the additional Chaos doesn't matter because... Well, it does matter. It's extra damage because all damage can ignite, no matter what damage you add to Hexblast, it can ignite. So, and since this has not been updated yet, it still says 40% more with elements. I still have zero doom set here, and I'm still using 180% more to pseudo do 60 doom Hexblast explosion. And this is the effective dis damage buff that Hexblast is getting from 150% to 210%. So this is basically just the additional damage from Martyr of Innocence. And if you get a Blizzard Crown instead of a Dodry Scorn, you're going to have to add you won't have to add it. It'll probably be updated by the time you're progressing onto the mid-tier version or the end-game version. POB will probably be updated with the damage effectiveness numbers, so you won't have to. You can delete all this once that's updated. But for now, it's dealing over 1 million Ignite DPS. Overall, we're going to be dealing about 2 million DPS on really bad gear. Just a Martyr of Innocence, which you're probably not going to get first day or maybe even second day. You can just use Ash Color Wands beforehand. And then config and remove these. So you can do like a 785,000, then 400,000 for Flamesters, that's 1.2 million, plus 200,000 for Scorching Ray. That's 1.4 million total DPS on like day one garbage gear. You're not going to have 2020 gems, of course, on day one, but even without the 2020 gems, you're still going to be dealing well over a million DPS with like garbage gear, day one stuff you can farm within the first day. Which is pretty good because it's consistent and your ignites are going to last quite a while. You got 7.63 second ignites, which means you just ignite the boss, recurse with flammability, and then just run in circles as your Scorching Ray totems deal additional extra damage, and then just applying Flame Surge whenever you need to, depending on how long it actually lasts. We have no idea how long Flame Surge lasts. So, but if you need to cast it often, that's fine because we have faster casting on it. It's going to make it easy, so... But that's just the update on the broke version. So the broke version is going to be pretty good, at least the League Start kind of version. It's going to be really good, actually. It has like 5,000 life. Forgot to mention, we have a Stone Golem. Where is it? We have a Stone Golem. These are great because now in the new patch, they're going to regenerate 2% of their life per second, which is fantastic. Which means they're going to survive a lot more. And since we added Vitality, we now have over 500 life regen, which is just fantastic. And then we're going to be using a forbidden taste when you take a savage hit, which is just going to be whenever you take a big hit, it's just going to instantly drop you, just bring you right back to 100% life, which is huge. And then we're going to have 500 life regen, which is pretty big. That's like effectively 10% life regen, more than 10% life regen. So that's pretty darn good. The reason we're degenning is from forbidden taste. But that's not going to matter because we just need a little more chaos resistance on gear. So you're just going to need to get a little bit of chaos resistance on gear, craft it on, and you're going to easily be at 75% because you get 63% from Withering Presence, which is huge. And why I actually suggest going Occultist first over Elementalist, just due to the additional chaos res and just how easy it is to cap chaos res with Occultist, because you're automatically at zero just by taking this node. So that's pretty big. And then you just need res on all your other gear. High res in your boots, high res in your amulet. If you can, craft on res and life and stuff. And then just get a high res ring, or you can get two high res rings and drop your damage down by a little bit. But pyre is good, a good early ring. So that's pretty much it. Peace out. This video is a bit longer than I expected it to be, but I just get really excited and I like sharing my stuff with you guys because you guys are I'm getting really positive reactions and it feels good. So peace out.